From about as far back as she can remember, Tierra wanted to be a mom. Now, part of that early longing for motherhood may have a lot to do with her own mother, who passed away when Tierra was only 5 years old. She has very few memories of her own mother, but the few she has are precious to her, and she strongly believes that the short amount of time she spent with her mom shaped her into the woman she is today. At 18, Tierra met Patrick, and it wasn't long after that that they got married. They wanted to start their own family quickly, but that proved to be easier said than done. They tried, then they moved around from state to state quite a bit. Then they tried some more. Nothing was happening. They gauged Tierra's window of fertility. She drank pineapple juice and checked her temperature often. Still, nothing but a lot of negative pregnancy tests. Her path to motherhood was not going to be an easy one. She wondered if God was trying to tell her something. When they moved back to Washington, they sought out a specialist and tried 3 rounds of IUI, or intrauterine insemination. Again, it was a no-go. Tierra was finally deemed infertile and could not get pregnant. Disappointing? Very much so. But the couple tried to keep their heads up. They talked about adopting, but just figured it might be too much of a hassle to even attempt. Soon after, a friend approached Tierra and started talking about her and Patrick fostering a child. Tierra really didn't want to deal with the idea of that at the time and put her off. She even dodged a few of her calls afterwards. She admits she was scared to think about it. But finally, she relented and heard her out. She told Tierra that their state desperately needed foster families to take children in, and the friend's husband even gave Patrick the male perspective of it all. When they left, Tierra and Patrick had a long talk about it. They prayed about it. Then they had another discussion about it. Together, they decided they really wanted to do it. They started their foster training in January of 2017. By June, they were officially licensed to take in children. They could not wait to take in any child who needed them, and they didn't have long to wait. On July 12th, they were contacted by the placement people. There was a little 15-month-old girl who was being moved from her current foster home because the foster mom was going back to school and would not have enough time to keep the girl. Tierra and Patrick were told the girl was shy and had attachment issues. The placement official then told Tierra and Patrick that the little girl was white and asked if that was okay. Patrick didn't hesitate and said, "She needs a home, right? Her race is not relevant." Ah, if only everyone could think and say that. Soon after that, they were brought a little girl named Felicity. She was scared and just did not understand why she was in new surroundings. Tierra said she cried for what seemed like a full 24 hours, and Felicity did not want Tierra to put her down. When her crying had stopped, it was Tierra who almost started to cry. She was emotionally drained and wondered if they had done the right thing by taking on a child. But one day, not too long after, Felicity started calling Tierra and Patrick Mommy and Daddy. Their hearts just melted. They had a good relationship with the birth mother, who would visit practically every week, and then she stopped. After a while, Tierra and Patrick realized there was probably no chance of reunification between Felicity and her birth mother. In early 2018, they got another call from the placement people. It was for a 5-day-old. He, too, was white. Tierra said yes, but things were put off for a while when the little boy had to be put on a feeding tube and oxygen. They said when he was born, he was severely drug exposed. He would need to be in the hospital another week, at least. When Patrick visited him one day during that week, he stopped breathing. Patrick did CPR on him, and everything was fine after that. 32 days later, they brought him home. They named him Samuel. 7 weeks later, the birth mother of Samuel sent Tierra a message saying she was pregnant again, and wondered if the couple would be able to take on this new child down the road. And they did. Judah was born on December 19th. All three of these children have since been adopted by Tierra and Patrick. Says Tierra, "I never thought I would ever be a mother, and I never thought I could love as hard as I do. Our skin may not match, but you cannot tell me or my kids that we aren't a family. We live in a predominantly white community, and we have not faced any hardships or racism. which I am so thankful for. Families do not have to match. As our kids get older, we're discussing race and color more and more. The kids know that our skin is different, but it doesn't matter to them. Though I said we haven't faced any racism, we do get the stares, especially when the kids are yelling, "Mommy and Daddy." Hopefully, any and all signs of racism will fade in the very near future, and all of them can live a happy and confident life. Please like, comment, and share. Join us and change lives. Pleased to have you around. Blessed we are to get connected with you.